resistance is a tendency to not want to accept corrections for misinformation that a person might hold. And the reasons for knowledge resistance are pretty varied. Well, first I should probably make it clear that people are willing to change their minds about some of their misunderstandings. Some things we have misconceptions about. You provide somebody with information, they say, oh, sure, I guess I was wrong about that. But then there's a whole suite of other things that people are wrong about and are, you know, just resistant to change their views. And for that second class of phenomena, they tend to be ideas or concepts or opinions that have consequences for somebody's values or their ideologies or the groups that they associate with, their tribes, if you will. Well, certainly the evidence of survey research doesn't show that. All the evidence that we have of Americans and Canadians show that people are pretty enthusiastic about science. They want to learn more about science. They think science is important. They think science has positive effects for society. And they want their kids to study science and even become scientists. No, it's a misconception that the anti-vaccination movement is largely a political left kind of thing. I think first you have to realize that the percentage of Americans who are anti-vax is minuscule. It's less than 5%. It's this tiny little percentage. The vast majority of Americans know that vaccinations are important. They know they save kids' lives and make them healthier and all that. And people do get their kids vaccinated. You know, it is close to the 93-95% that the CDC wants us to have. So you're actually dealing with a very small amount of variation, number one. But even with that small amount of variation, you don't see a strong tendency for either political left or political right. You see some of both, or some of each, I guess would be better grammar. You see some tendency for anti-vaxxers to be left-wing, some tendency to be right-wing, but there's no strong tendency overall for either right or left. People reject the sciences, the specific sciences that tend to gore their oxen. If accepting a particular science or a particular view within science is going to have consequences for values or ideologies that you hold dear, you're not going to want to change them. Ideologies are like operations. They can be good or bad. It all depends on the context. Everybody has ideologies. They can be benign and they can be toxic. Having ideologies is a very human thing. And ideologies are the way that we decide how to live and how to treat each other. So, no, I don't think ideologies are bad at all. I think some ideologies are worth fighting against, but everybody has ideologies, and it's silly to assume that because I'm a scientist, because I try to look at the world rationally and logically, that therefore ideology is unimportant, because it's important for everybody. I think skeptics don't do enough listening. We talk about how do we talk to people who are anti-evolutionists, or how do we talk to climate change deniers? Well, maybe we should listen to them. We need to find out what it is about evolution or what it is about climate change that is making people resistant to change their minds. Because it is quite possible to find common ground, even with somebody who initially disagrees with your opinion. I know the most about anti-evolutionists because I've spent most of my professional career dealing with the anti-evolution movement, and I know a lot of conservative Christians. I've met and talked with a lot of anti-evolutionists. And the major concern for a very large number of people who initially appear to not, you know, want their kids to learn evolution, or they believe they reject evolution, is when evolution is packaged as something that goes along with a disbelief in God. In other words, you have to take the whole package. You have to be both an atheist and an evolutionist, which of course is empirically wrong. I mean, we have plenty of evidence that there are people of faith who accept evolution and would teach classes in evolution the same way I would teach classes in evolution. What I find conservative Christians most concerned about is that if their children are taught evolution in the schools, they're taught, here's the evidence for evolution, scientists agree that living things had common ancestors, now take your religion and shove it. And once you sort of get that belief in people's minds, you need to get that belief out of there, because that's not what evolution is all about. I mean, nobody says, here's cell division, here's how the chromosomes line up in the midline, here are the enzymes that form the spindle fibers that pull the cells across, now take your religion and shove it. Nobody even thinks about looking at all other aspects of science like that. So why all of a sudden does evolution have to be an atheistic science? Evolution is no more atheistic than cell division.